have carte blanche to exert unspeakable brutality against the inmates. Its methods are constant intimidation, torture, rape, and murder. Responsibility for these acts reach to the highest levels of government. For example, so many lives were lost that day that might have been saved if the governor of New York, himself scion of one of the richest families in the world, had shown the tolerance and compassion which his office and privileged position mandated. Finally, it was a question of the right of the state to enforce its power over the individual, no matter how arbitrary and oppressive its methods. It is sad to think of that deplorable time, that terrible day in September. Just 1 month prior, there had been another tragedy at Soledad Prison in California, resulting in several deaths, most notably that of a 30-year-old Black Panther, George Jackson. It's a tragic fact that over 50% of the prisoners in Attica were Black, even though at the time African Americans numbered less than 15% of the total population, according to the National Bureau of Census. The 1960s and 70s marked a period of epical social and cultural change worldwide, particularly among youth. People like George Jackson and those who perished in Attica were symbolic of courage. In the face of injustice and adversity, certainly some gave their lives hoping to change the world. Unfortunately, not much has changed. Sometimes things seem to be even worse. Perhaps we are all prisoners.
Thank you. été chanté un morceau écrit par Calvin Messi. En fait, nous étions en tournée dans les années 60, il a écrit cette chanson. C'est une dédicace pour Eldridge Cleaver, en fait. On s'appelle Quiet Dawn. Quiet Dawn, chanté par Nico. Prochain morceau, j'écris, c'est une dédicace pour George Jackson, qui était tristement assassiné dans une prison de Californie. Je l'appelle Blues for Brother George Jackson. Thank you.
Yeah.